So you guys really seem to enjoy our video about what if Thor was a herald of Galactus. And so what we're going to do, because Marvel's launching the Thor Corps after the events of Secret Wars, because we're basically going to see every single version of Thor that exists in the Thor Corps stories, I figured, why not do another one? And in this video, we're going to be talking about the What If series. What if Jane Foster had the power of Thor? So this What If story is a widely loved story among Thor fans. What we're also going to find here is this story is going to be the basis behind the theories that exist that the current Thor, who is a woman, is actually Jane Foster. Now, the way this story plays out, if you recall our video about Thor, is much the same way that the original Thor had played out in the Earth 616 continuity. This is to say that Donald Blake had an affection for Jane Foster. Jane Foster was his nurse. But the difference here is that in our original video, we had talked about how Donald Blake had gone on a holiday on his own. He had gone on a holiday by himself to basically reflect his lot in life, to reflect whether or not he should really say anything to Jane Foster. But in this continuity, Jane Foster goes with him. And so what happens when the aliens land and they presume, or I guess begin their attempt to take over the planet Earth, that Jane Foster and Donald Blake try to escape. But as they're both climbing over a mountainside, much like the original version of Thor in Earth 616, Donald Blake drops his cane. But instead of him going to get it, Jane Foster is the one that tries to go get it. But instead, she falls down the hill. And so while Donald Blake is able to find refuge in a rock, Jane Foster finds the cave whereby the hammer of Thor is hidden. And so much like the original continuity of Thor in Earth 616, Jane Foster finds this stick, which she gets frustrated over because she doesn't really have a way out. And as a result, when she smacks the stick on a rock, she learns, or I guess she develops the powers of Thor. Now, this is where the theories about the current Thor come from, because Jane Foster has brunette. She's a dark-haired woman, but when she possesses the power of Thor, she immediately turns blonde. In addition to this, she actually adopts the name of Thordis for a while. And again, this is really just a way for her to basically pay homage to the original Thor, the person whose powers that she's gained here. And so what happens is, much like, again, our continuity from Earth 616 and with regards to Thor, we find that Loki eventually escapes his captivity. And when he does, he seeks out revenge against Thor. But when he tries to find Thor, he ultimately finds Jane Foster. And so as a result, he attempts a ruse to basically get Jane Foster to hand the hammer over by creating an illusion of the actual Thor. But when Jane Foster sees through it, she defeats Loki and she sends him back to Asgard. And so what Loki does here is he tells Odin that Thor has returned. And so Odin recalls Thor to Asgard, but when this version of Thor arrives, it turns out to actually be Jane Foster. And so as a result, Odin feels as though something's gone wrong, but in the end, the hammer found its rightful owner, I guess the person who is most worthy of wielding it. And so as a result, he simply just banishes Jane Foster away from Asgard for eternity. Now what happens here is that I guess Jane Foster undergoes the process of basically going through and having more or less her own career here. That is to say, she becomes a founding member of this alternate realities version of the Avengers. She also goes on to fight various criminals and masterminds and so on and so forth, but she maintains this double life of being Jane Foster and having a relationship with Donald Blake, but also being a superhero. And so all this really seems to come to a head when Jane Foster realizes that Ragnarok is coming. Now again, Ragnarok is a concept we discussed in our Thor video. And so what happens is she seeks out Sif, as well as traveling back to Asgard and to warn Odin. But the problem here is that Odin has fallen into the Odin sleep. And so as a result, there's no one here to really protect Asgard aside from Thordis and the few remaining Asgards who are able to hold off Ragnarok. And so what takes place here is they eventually end up confronting a being called Mangog, which of course we've talked about him as well. And as a result, Thordis is successful in being able to hold off Ragnarok. Now, what we learn is that as a result of this, that Thordis eventually hands the hammer back over to Donald Blake. And at this point, Donald Blake has basically turned his back on Jane Foster, the reason being because during the entire conflict, he had ultimately come into contact with Lady Sif. And as a result, he had fallen in love with Lady Sif and fallen out of love with Jane Foster. Now, again, this is really more of a byproduct of the fact that Donald Blake was trying to deal with having a relationship with Jane Foster while she was balancing a double life. And so in truth, she just didn't really have enough time for him. And so as a result, we found that once the hammer was, I guess, given up by Thordis, by Jane Foster, and given back to Donald Blake, Donald Blake had taken on his form of Thor. What we had also found was Odin had reawakened, and as a result, because of the bravery that was demonstrated by Jane Foster, that Odin had basically granted her godlike powers, had made her a goddess. And so what he did is, because Jane Foster had basically lost the love of her life in the form of Donald Blake to Lady Sif, and because she was basically immortal now, she had to simply spend the rest of her life without Donald Blake, Odin had basically proposed to her, and she had become his wife in this continuity. Now, the reason why, again, a lot of us who read this story believe this, this is basically pointing to the idea that the new female version of Thor may be Jane Foster, is because, again, when this version of Jane Foster gained the power of Thor, she went from being a brunette to a red, I'm sorry, to a blonde woman. Now, this only happens whenever she possesses the power of Thor, whenever she takes on that power. In addition, the power of Thor grants this bearer for almost godlike power, and so as a result, any illnesses or ailments that they had are immediately removed away from them. And so as a result, we could basically see this taking place with the Earth 616 version of Jane Foster, who has cancer. It's entirely possible for her to possess the power of Thor and for her to basically be in a godlike state, but then revert back to her normal state once that power of Thor goes away. But again, this is really one of the big holes in the theory. This is kind of something that we really can't get past here. But the fact remains that if with the Marvel Universe being what it is, especially looking at the Age of Ultron, what we found was that after the events of Age of Ultron, whereby Wolverine had effectively broken time, that Galactus from the Earth 616 continuity was sent to the Ultimate Universe. And so the question that a lot of us had was, if it's possible for Wolverine to have damaged time in such a way that a being like Galactus was transported to an alternate reality, is it possible that Jane Foster could be yanked away from her reality to the Earth 616 continuity? And in learning that Thor could no longer wield the power of Thor anymore, he could no longer wield a hammer, that she took it in its place? And because remember, this version of Jane Foster from this alternate reality has godlike powers, meaning that, or not necessarily godlike powers, but she's immortal, meaning that she could effectively wield Thor's hammer because she's already been worthy of doing it. She can breathe in outer space, hence the reason she was able to travel to the moon. There's a lot of reasons here for us to believe this might be the version of this new version of Thor. But again, there's also just as many holes as there are supporting beams for this entire theory. But nonetheless, this is just one of the cooler stories with regards to this version of Thor. But if you guys are interested, we can jump into other versions of Thor. We can talk about Beta Ray Bill. We can talk about alternate reality versions of Thor. What if Thor had taken a different road, and so on and so forth. But with that being said, we're going to go ahead and bring this video to an end. I hope you guys enjoyed. I know it was a short one, but this is also a really short story too. It's really not that in-depth, but I will catch you guys later. Peace. Be sure to follow me on Twitter. There you can keep up with all the updates from Comics Explained and talk to me directly. I'm standing up by myself in the shadows, surrounded by the silence seeping in. Alone with my thoughts, no one to find.